friends, I extend my revolutionary salutes to all those who gathered here to strengthen our democratic culture in JNU. Myself, Amal PP, contesting for the post of Vice President from Left Unity Panel. Friends, recently our Prime Minister said, the nationalists are already with us. Now we have to mobilize SCSTs and OBCs. What he mean by this? It is very clear that if you are belonging to SCST, you are an anti-national. If you are belonging to other backward community, you are an anti-national. If you are a worker protesting for your wage and life conditions, you are an anti-national. If you are from Northeast or from South India who reject the RSS idea of Hindi nationalism, you are an anti-national. If you are from Kashmir protesting for the democratic rights, you are an anti-national. If you are protesting for the LGBT rights, you are an anti-national. And if you are a JNU student, of course, you are an anti-national. Let me say, I am standing here with the one among of this anti-national. Friends, this is a crucial time. We are facing our JNUSU election. The prime educational institutions of our country are facing severe threat. The direct attack on higher educational institutions are started from Chennai IIT, then Pune Film Institute, Hyderabad Central University, JNU, Allahabad University, Jadavpur University, Himachal Pradesh University, Calicut University, IFLU, Pondicherry University. Friends, why they are attacking these higher educational institutions? This is because the voice of dissent is first coming from these educational institutions. And these institutions represent the diversity of our country. Friends, we have to continue our fight. We have to strengthen our movement. From the beginning of our students' union movement in the early 1970s, social justice is one of the prime agenda of our students' union movement. By 1974, the implementation of deprivation action point was there. And there is, we know that continuous struggles for hostels, still we are leading here. Our administration is giving 3-star or 5-star facilities for their office people. But the common students of JNU, they are lying down in the streets and counting stars. We have to fight against this kind of administration things. Friends, we have to fight more for reducing of viva weightage. So, friends, they said that you have to shut down JNU. But we said, fight back JNU and stand with JNU. And what stand with JNU means? From a deprived community, person like me, who can come and take admission here less than 300 rupees. We can take hostel room for 100 rupees rent for month. We can access free Wi-Fi here. We can access 24/7 library here. We can access journal free here. We are not saying JNU is a perfect idea. Here is so many issues are here. Issues of social justice are here. Issues of gender justice are here. But with our continuous struggles and movement, we have to strengthen our movement for our rights. Friends, we are the first university in India established GS cash in our university. Friends, friends, we have to strengthen more our fight to implement the correct reservation policies here. Friends, on the one side, there is the common people of India is struggling so much against the policies of the government because they are cutting down the subsidies. The prices are continuously increasing and there is serious caste atrocities, communal attack on common people of the country. And there is a serious threat of our democracy. There is the Sangha Parivar forces like Gorakshak and the Vanara Senas are continuously attacking all our common people. So from JNU, we are standing with the people, they are protesting in Kashmir. We are standing with the people, they are leading the movement for their LGBT rights. From JNU, we are standing with the people, they are continuing their fight against caste atrocities. From JNU, we are standing with the people, they are protesting for the workers' rights. Friends, this is a crucial time. I am requesting all of you to give a clear mandate of this left unity panel to strengthen our fight and our movement this time. I am introducing my panel in front of you. Mohit Kumar Pandey for President, Amal PP for Vice President, Chakrabai Chakravarti for General Secretary and Tabarish Hassan for Joint Secretary. Please vote and support, elect this panel to strengthen our fight. Jai Bhim Lal Salaam.
How is the fight to resolve the hostile crisis in you if you are elected? Is there some example from the past when the student union in the JNU has fought successfully for hostels?
Before I going to answer this question, I just want to tell you that some people are shouted while I am speaking here. So I am a person, I studied in a regional language till my master's time. I'm trying to speak in English in this time. So it is so many limitations we have this time. So this is the, I believe this is the beauty of JNU. Diversity of the campuses and any person from the different background who can come and study here. So I just, Friends, we have a history of continuous struggles for hostels. In 1997, under the leadership of Comrade Bhattilal Bhairava, the union continuously fought against administration for hostel accommodation. That time, administration forced to provide accommodation outside with the travel facilities. We have a history of that. And in 1998, under the leadership of Comrade Viju Krishnan, the Students' Union of JNU fought a militant struggle and finally 63 students were arrested and 14 of them were jailed in Tehar, including 3 JNU officers. After that, administration is forced to build the hostel Tapti to Chandrabhaga. So we have a great history of that. We know our condition. 90% of the newcomers are still outside. They don't get the hostels. And the MA students, they don't have hostels and they're not going to get MCM also. We have to fight against this. We have to fight against this administration. And this is a continuous struggle. First, if I got elected, one of the first agenda of my union will be ensure the alternative accommodation. So, my friends from ABEP, they came and talking about the hostel crisis here. So, I hope that they will tell about the number of hostels in DU, the campus conservation, their union, and they will tell about their hostel achievements and accommodation in DU. The government is also there ruling and the JNUSU is also there in power.
What do you have done to check social discrimination in CIPD in your school?
As a SIS convener, I want to share some of my experience to you. That there is a discriminatory and elitist criteria was there in the center of CITD. There was only BA honors people can take admission there. Last to last year, five students were denied admission finally. And we protested in front of SIS, and finally, five of them took back, and three of the students from regional background and deprived communities. But we achieved that, and finally, they scrapped this criteria from CITD. And there is no problem with CITD. There is many of the centers like Seaport. About Seaport, there is continuously complaints are coming. Complaints on social justice and complaints on various issues. So let me tell you that all these issues and issues on residence and also 36 students, they got 1 or 2 marks in YUA. We are present.